Iron deficiency, what you need to know when your iron levels are low. This is Ben, and he is 20 years old. Ben was diagnosed with iron deficiency anemia, and today we are going to walk through what a day in his life looks like. His condition causes him to feel fatigued through most of the day, and he frequently experiences headaches. After climbing a flight of stairs or exercising, he experiences shortness of breath and becomes lightheaded. His skin looks pale and has become dry, causing him to lose the glow he once had, and he has recently noticed his nails had become brittle and broke easily. Other symptoms that Ben experiences include cold hands and feet, poor appetite, and unusual craving for non-nutritive substances such as ice and starch. Ben should have 4 to 5 grams of iron stored in his body in order to maintain healthy levels. Of this, 65% of iron is stored in the form of hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is a protein that is found in red blood cells that assists in transporting oxygen throughout the body. First, the oxygen molecule, as shown in blue, binds to available hemoglobin molecules in the red blood cell. Once the red blood cell reaches an area of the body that requires oxygen, the oxygen is released from the hemoglobin. Around 1 to 2% of iron is stored in the form of heme. Heme is a ring-shaped molecule that is found within hemoglobin, which is able to bind iron. In the case of hemoglobin, each hemoglobin molecule contains 4 heme groups. The final 30 to 35% of iron is stored in the liver in the form of ferritin, which is a protein. Ferritin regulates the amount of iron in the body by storing it and releasing it as necessary. A ferritin test is a blood test that can be done to determine if Ben does not store enough iron and can be used as one type of diagnostic tool for iron deficiency. Iron plays a role in many processes in the body. A large portion of our daily intake of iron is used for red blood cell production. Iron is also involved in the creation of energy for the body. Iron further plays a role in cell growth and differentiation of cells into different types of cells. Iron is also able to regulate the expression of certain genes. Due to Ben's iron deficiency, some or all of these functions may not be performing optimally, which could cause some of the symptoms that Ben experiences. Iron deficiency anemia is a common type of anemia that occurs if you do not have enough iron in your body. So what is causing Ben to have iron deficiency? Iron deficiency anemia develops over time because Ben's body's iron levels are too low. Low intake of iron can happen because of blood loss, consuming less than the recommended daily amounts of iron, and medical conditions that makes it hard for one's body to absorb iron from the digestive tract. When you lose blood, you lose iron. Certain conditions and medicines can cause blood loss and lead to iron deficiency anemia. Common causes of blood loss include bleeding in your digestive tract as a result of ulcers or colon cancer, regular use of medicines such as aspirin or anti-inflammatory medicine such as Advil, frequent blood donations or blood tests, heavy menstrual periods for women, as well as injuries and surgeries. Iron deficiency can also be caused if an individual consumes less than the recommended daily amounts of iron. The recommended daily amounts of iron depend on one's age, gender, and whether the individual is pregnant or breastfeeding. This is a chart from National Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute showing the recommended daily amounts of iron that should be consumed. In Ben's case, since he is a 20-year-old male, he would fall into this category, which means that it is recommended that he consumes 8 milligrams of iron per day. Another cause of iron deficiency may be due to problems absorbing iron. Even if you consume the recommended daily amounts of iron, your body may not be able to absorb iron. Certain conditions and medicines can decrease the body's ability to absorb iron and lead to iron deficiency anemia. These conditions include intestinal and digestive conditions, such as celiac disease or inflammatory bowel disease, a history of gastrointestinal surgery, such as weight loss surgery, and certain rare genetic conditions, such as a mutation that causes a person's body to block the intestine from absorbing iron. We will discuss the three stages of iron deficiency for you to better understand the progression of iron deficiency anemia. The first stage is iron store depletion, where iron stores are low and there is low ferritin level. Ferritin, in other words, is how iron is stored in the body. At this stage, there are usually no symptoms attributed to low ferritin levels. But what happens when the condition progresses? The second stage is iron-deficient erythropoiesis. Erythropoiesis is the process of creating red blood cells. During this stage, the transportation of iron decreases and is characterized by a lower production and size of red blood cells. At this stage, symptoms include fatigue and having a lack of energy, as well as having slower cognitive abilities. The third and final stage is iron deficiency anemia, where red blood cells are fewer in number, smaller, and contain less hemoglobin. This is also known as a late stage and results in severe symptoms seen with iron deficiency anemia. In Ben's case, he's in the third stage and starts to feel extreme fatigue, weakness, headaches, poor immune function, and a lower ability to do physical work. His physician has prescribed him oral iron supplements to increase his iron levels to alleviate any symptoms. Ben has been advised to take his medication with vitamin C pills or orange juice to increase absorption of iron. Other treatments include the delivery of iron-rich fluid through IV, specifically for those where iron absorption at the level of intestine is compromised. As for preventions, iron deficiency anemia can be prevented through implementation of an iron-rich diet. This includes red meat, tofu, fruits, especially those with a higher vitamin C content, legumes, leafy greens, and broccoli. It is important not to consume these enhancers at the same time you do for inhibitors, as they will inhibit the absorption of iron. And these include coffee and tea, milk, corn, and chocolate.
Thank you for watching the video, and we hope that this helped you learn more about iron deficiency anemia. If you are interested to further your knowledge, please refer to the following website at the National Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute,